My music, I'd call it, it's a New Southwest music that really fuses the influences that I grew up with here in New Mexico, like Native American, Hispanic, as well as the Western and the cowboy, with a good deal of rock thrown in there too. Originally, Native American flute music was inspired by sounds of nature. And, you know, I really feel like my ears are probably the most sensitive sense that I have. So I really experience the world through hearing things. My music definitely tries to capture nature at its most harmonious, whether it be the sunrise or the sunset. There is a direct correlation, a direct connection between what I'm playing and what I'm experiencing, and I only hope that that comes through. When I'm performing, it definitely feels like I'm doing exactly what I should be doing. I live less than a half a mile from the Rio Grande River, and I would watch the sunrise over the Oregon Mountains. And you can really hear the entire valley just coming to life, and the birds are singing, and the flies are buzzing. And so I was trying to capture that. In southwestern New Mexico is a very primordial feeling place. The topography, the geography of the land, it's so fertile and it's so green and just immediately peaceful. When you look to the west, you can see the old the volcanoes. When you look at the mountains and just on the other side, knowing that white sands is there, you really get a sense and a feeling of place there. It's very fertile, it's very green, it's very quiet, but I think the biggest thing is I really get the feeling from Las Cruces that it could exist that way whether we were there or not. Going from the Pecos Mountains down to the Rio Grande, down to the Llano Estacado and the Cap Rock of southeastern New Mexico, you discover something different every single time you walk out your door, and I think that's my favorite thing about New Mexico.